The perturbative approach to shear bands is an investigation on the behavior of a material subject to large deformation and consequent large stress. For a nonlinear elastic incompressible material subject to plane strain deformation, the state of stress can be represented in a parametric plane where in the horizontal axis there is the state deviatoric state of pre-stress sigma 1 minus sigma 2 normalized with respect to the incremental shear modulus, and on the vertical axis there is the ratio between the two incremental shear moduli. So this representation can be divided into several regions. Particularly, there is an elliptic region which can be subdivided into an elliptic imaginary and elliptic complex regions. And then there is the hyperbolic zone here and the parabolic region here. So the classic approach to shear bands is that shear bands are impossible in the elliptic regime, so they do not occur. They become possible in the hyperbolic and in the parabolic regime. In the hyperbolic regime there are four shear bands, and in the parabolic regime there are two. And a material subject to increasing pre-stress has a path, follows a path in this plane. For instance, the path shown red is the behavior of a J2 deformation theory material. So initially the material starts unloaded here, and then under continuous loading it goes like this. Initially it goes in the elliptic complex regime, and then the elliptic boundary is touched here, and then the material enters in the hyperbolic region. So formally, using the classic approach, shear bands are only possible when the stress state touches this boundary. The idea of the perturbative approach is to analyze the response of the material pre-stressed in a uniform way near the border of ellipticity, and in particular at increasing state of pre-stress. So at different level of pre-stress the material is perturbed, for instance adding a concentrated force or adding or analyzing the effect of a rigid line inclusion, a so-called stiffener, or imposing a fracture, and plotting the mechanical fields, the incremental stress, the incremental displacement or incremental deformation, and the behavior of the material changes the incremental response in a way that usually shear bands or emerge near the border of ellipticity loss. For instance, we will present soon two analytic solutions which are plotted at different level of pre-stress and incrementally perturbed through a mode 1 or mode 2 stress at infinity. So in the first case we will see a stiffener which is parallel to the current state of pre-stress and perturbed through a mode 1 or mode 2 state of stress, incremental stress at infinity, and we will see that when we will approach the border of ellipticity loss there will be localized solution emerging in this form near the tip of the stiffener, and in the second case the stiffener will be parallel to a simple shear, and so that for simple shear the state of stress will rotate during pre-stress, and we will see that the solutions to the response to a perturbation are actually a mode 1 incremental perturbation will be near the border of ellipticity like this. There will be a shear band horizontal plus another inclined like this. There is no symmetry here, so the difference in the inclination of these shear bands came from the fact that this is a fully there is this axis of symmetry here and there is no symmetry here due to the inclination of pre-stress. Let's look now at these two situations.